this book was conceived with the idea that the various fields of public health, health administration, health policy needs a book on systems thinking. All of those fields utilize systems thinking. In fact, they have it in their core competencies. A lot of professors teach it, but there's not a book, and this is the one, there's not a book that addresses that across that full spectrum. So systems thinking, you know, many of you know what that is, but systems thinking is the idea that throughout society there are interconnections across different domains, across among different people, different populations. And if we're going to do public health or engage in any type of health improvement, health promotion, we need to better understand those connections. And systems thinking provides a series of tools and concepts that allow us to better understand that. Systems thinking also addresses the concept of interdependency and interdependency, that various segments of a society, various sectors, depend on each other. You know of the concept One Health. You know the concept of WHO promotes health in all policies. The idea that that we have to work across domains. Public health is not limited to health care. It's not limited to medical care. It's much broader. It involves environment, involves agriculture, transportation, housing, urbanization. All of that is part of public health, and systems thinking allows us to understand it with those kinds of linkages and interconnections. Likewise, in the book, we talk about clinical care, and we talk about health administration and policy. So it's not limited to public health. So the idea behind that is we want the same mindset, clinicians to think in terms of systems thinking, administrators to embrace systems thinking, so that they too are looking across domains, looking at interconnections, interdependencies, and so forth. The other thing we do in the book, and I think this is absolutely important, is we have cases, real cases, where systems thinking has been applied in organizations, hospitals, public health agencies, clinical practice, and so forth. The book is also quite full of diagrams, illustrations to show how systems thinking tools can be used to help improve a particular health situation.